Creatine is one of the most popular muscle-building supplements out there, but research is starting to show that creatine does more than make people stronger. Today, let's look at the proof for creatine supplements helping people who have fibromyalgia. Now, one of the reasons why people started looking into this is that some studies suggest that individuals with fibromyalgia have lower levels of creatine in their muscles. Now, this begs the question whether or not you could actually improve fibromyalgia symptoms by giving people creatine supplements. Fortunately, there is some research on this. Now, from what I was able to determine, the very first report of this came out in 2006 and involved a 52-year-old kindergarten teacher who's dealing with fibromyalgia and PTSD. She takes creatine supplements for 1 month and reports that not only did her depression get better, but also so too did her fibromyalgia symptoms. It's reported that her fibromyalgia tender points were less tender, her sleep improved significantly, and her quality of life was said to be improved by 30%. So overall, pretty impressive results from creatine, although I do want to point out that this is not actually a clinical trial. Rather, this is a report of a single individual. So fortunately, however, our story does not end here. We have some more proof to cover. Next up is an investigation that comes to us from Israel, where 30 women with fibromyalgia who were not responding well to conventional fibromyalgia therapies were given creatine supplements for 8 weeks. And just as before, these women also reported significantly less pain when they were taking creatine supplements. So overall, sounds like another win for creatine, although I will point out that this paper did not include a placebo group, so that's one drawback. Another problem with this investigation is they started with 30 women, but only 16 of them completed the study. That's a 47% dropout rate. Now, we're not quite sure why everybody dropped out. However, some women did report having trouble swallowing the creatine tablets that they were given during the study. I know what you're thinking. Why didn't they just use creatine powder? And that's a really good question, and it's one I asked myself. But our story doesn't end here. This all brings us to this next paper, which purports to be the very first randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trial of creatine supplements and fibromyalgia. For 16 weeks, 32 women with fibromyalgia are given either creatine supplements or a sugar pill as a placebo. For the first week of the trial, women were given 20 grams of creatine a day, split up into 4 equal doses of 5 grams, and then after that, they took 5 grams of creatine each day for the rest of the study. Now, one part of this study that I thought was very interesting is that they had these women perform before and after strength tests. In other words, they had the women do a 1-repetition maximum strength test on the chest press machine and a leg press machine. 1-repetition maximum means they were lifting the most weight they can only lift one time, which to me didn't make sense because we're talking about people who are already in widespread pain. Why would you go ahead and have them lift multiple sets of very heavy weights? Now, from a scientific perspective, I get why they did it, but from a pain perspective, I don't know why they had them lift such heavy weights. But regardless, what happened in this study? So it's reported that the people taking creatine had about an 80% increase in creatine levels in their muscles, which is no surprise. Creatine is well known to raise muscle creatine levels. Those people also got about 9% stronger on the leg press and about 1% stronger on the chest press. Again, no real surprise there. Creatine is well known to improve muscle strength. Now, here's where things get a little interesting. So it's reported that people taking creatine had a somewhat elevated improvement in their overall mental health, but there was no improvement in fibromyalgia symptoms. In other words, creatine didn't help them sleep any better or reduce their pain level either. Now, on the plus side, there were no side effects reported, and that also included no kidney problems either. So from the results of this study, it might be concluded that creatine does not help people with fibromyalgia. However, there are a few things you need to know. Number one, everybody in this study was allowed to continue with their traditional fibromyalgia medications. In other words, this study doesn't say anything about whether creatine by itself might help fibromyalgia symptoms. They also discussed in the study of whether or not they had enough people to accurately figure out whether creatine worked or not. Bottom line here, I would like this study also replicated with a larger number of people to see whether creatine works or not. Here's a breakdown of the amounts of creatine used in the summaries that I just summarized in this video. And as you can see, 5 grams per day is pretty much the norm for these papers. So in other words, you don't have to take much if you're going to try this for yourself. And at this point in time, I don't see any reason why anybody would have to start taking 20 grams a day for the very first week. However, if the results of the first two papers are indeed valid, it means that taking only 5 grams a day should start yielding positive results after about a month. Now, if you're not familiar with creatine and you go shopping for it in those local stores or online, you're going to see different types of creatine out there. And I'm going to suggest that you bypass all these different types out there and go with the one that has most of the clinical research, like 99% of that clinical research, and that's called creatine monohydrate. I would suggest opting for creatine powder over creatine capsules or tablets because they're easier to swallow. And some people also mix creatine powder with juice to increase its absorption. I'll link to a brand that I like below to get you started. But in general, don't worry about any brand of creatine that has fancy marketing words on the label like micronized or concentrated because they can just cost more. Now, creatine supplements have been studied for decades, and literally there are hundreds of clinical trials on creatine. The majority of those papers do show that creatine monohydrate is safe, although I would also point out that most of those papers are also involving generally healthy people who do not have fibromyalgia. And so because of that, if you do have fibromyalgia or other existing problems such as kidney problems, diabetes, etc., absolutely talk to your doctor first before you try creatine to see if it's right for you.